Wait a minute. He said from the one time he talked to you, he fell in love with you.
Yeah.
Hmm.
That's what he said. He said, when I talked to you, he said, you said, people don't know how to raise children no more.
Mm-hmm.
I said, they let these children tell them what to do instead of you telling them what to do. I said, when my kids was growing up, they were scared of my boys.
Right.
And I said, I just had to say so. I said, they would obey. And he said, well, if I had any kids, that's what mine would go. I said, I was going to do mine. He right.
Well, we weren't scared of your voice, mamas. We were scared of getting smacked in the back and in the back of the head.
Well, I'm just saying, I was talking to him. And he said, the first day when we and you had a conversation, he said, the first day when me and him had a conversation, he fell in love with me.
Okay.
And what he said? He did. He said, Miss Sarah, I want you to give me your phone number because I'm going to call you sometime. And I was like, okay.
Okay.
But I didn't think nothing of it.
Right.
And he's been calling me ever since.
Oh, okay.
He calls me. I told him, I said, you didn't have to buy me no mask. He said, I know I didn't have to. I wanted to.
Right.
I said, well, it better not make me sick. He just bought
it. Right.
He said, it's not the mask. It's not the mask. Because these masks came from California. I'm thinking, damn, maybe somebody in California put some on.
Right.
And he's talking about, you need to stop letting your mind reach that far. Because you... It's because you being extra now.
You being extra.
Huh?
I said, he said, you being extra.
Because I said the people in California might have put some on it.
Mm.
He just be saying all kinds of stuff. It tickles me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what he said. He said, on the day one when me and him had that conversation, he said, because everything you said reminded me of my grandmama.
Mm-hmm.
His grandmama, he said, because his grandmama was strict. He said his grandmama would go get a switch steel when he growing up. He said, and he ain't numbered by 20-something. Coming, his grandmama would go get a switch and whoop them.
Mm.
He said she was old school, and she would say, she just, he said, he was, she said, they said, go get a what? And he said, I'm going to take you out here and show you what a switch is. So she took him outside, because she was in the little country part of Alabama, you know.
Right.
So then she said, go out there and get a switch. And he said, what's a switch?
Right.
She said, I'm going to take you outside and show you what a switch is. So when next time when I tell you to come out here and get one, you know what kind of getting, what size.
So did she take him out there and whoop his tail?
Yeah. And she took him out there and showed him what kind of switch he was. And he said, then when they came back in the house, he didn't think nothing about it. And she said, Landon, come here. And he said, he came in there and she said, take your pants off. He said, well, I thought she was going to try me on a pair of pants or hem up some pants because she did stuff like it, right?
Right.
He was a little boy. He said he was about 3 when he started getting them switches on them legs. He said he took them pants off and them switches got on. He said, oh, he didn't know what to do.
Right, he was in shock.
He was running and hands were throwing up in the air and realized he wasn't going nowhere but round in a circle because she had him by a shirt. He was just running around, and she said he was just tearing him up. He said, that's the reason why I just said I love this lady. Said she's like she grew up in the house with me.
Right.
That's what he said. He said he wasn't going nowhere. Just run around in a circle. Said she was tearing his little legs up, and she said he said from then on he didn't do nothing.
Oh God, no, he didn't.
He said 3 years old, honey. He said he know what yes ma'am and no ma'am means.
Right.
And he said, you always be respectful at all times.
Mm.
And to adults, and you should always be nice to people.
Right.
And he is like it, too. He said, that's the reason why he would say, so no, you're not going to do that. Yeah, that's what he used to do at work.
Okay.
He said, no, I'm going to do it, and I'm going to let you do this.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he didn't feel like he was going to do it, it just didn't get done. That white boy didn't care. He just didn't do it.
Right. Oh, so Landon is white.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Landon. defending his wife.
Okay.
And he said that's what his grandma told him. Come on, I'm gonna take that side and show you what a switch is, so you'll know what you kind of size to get and kind to get. Yeah, he's white. He's white. He sure is white.
Bless his heart.
He said he went on out there telling my grandmama his word. This is a good one. All that old kind of stuff, but he didn't know what was going on.
Right. Bless his heart.
And he said she got back in there, telling him to come in. He came and said, pull your pants off. He said, just pulled them off because she said, pull them off.
Right.
And she said, he at the back of that chair was standing them legs up. He said, he just running. He said, then I realized I wasn't going nowhere. She had the back of that chair and I was just running around the circle. I just. He said, from then on, you did whatever she said.
Right.
He said, you didn't argue, you didn't backtalk.
Mm-mm. Because you did not want to go out there and get no sweat.